subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see how to solve the problems of clocks and calendars. Okay, first let's learn what are the basics of clocks and calendars, so that if you understand the basic formula only, you will be able to solve any kind of problem. So first let's start with calendars. Okay, so coming to calendars, we need to first understand what is odd day. Okay, what is odd day? Extra days after a complete week. Extra days after a complete week are odd days. What does this mean? See, coming to 1 year, in 1 year we will have 52 weeks. In 1 year there will be 52 weeks. Okay, so but in leap year, I'll say you what is leap year. In normal year will have 365 days. Normal year will have 365 days, which is nothing but 52 weeks. Okay, normal year will have 365 days, which is 52 weeks. But leap year will have 366 days. 366 days means 52 weeks plus 1 day. See, 52 weeks, complete 52 weeks plus 1 extra day. This extra day is called odd day. Okay, after counting the complete weeks, whatever additional and extra days are there, those days are called odd days. Okay, so now let's see what is leap year and non-leap year. First let's see what is non-leap year. Non-leap year means the normal year. Every year we will have 365 days, right? That is called 365 days, right? That is called non-leap year. Coming to leap year, there will be one extra day in the year, which is 366 days. Okay, I'm repeating. In non-leap year, there will be only 365 days, which is a normal year. And coming to the leap year, there will be 366 days. That is one extra day compared to the normal year. Okay. Okay. So now let's see how to calculate how to calculate leap year. Okay. Coming to the leap year, we already know there will be 366 days in a year, which is 52 weeks plus 1 odd day. Odd day is extra day is called odd day. Okay. Okay. So coming to leap year comes once in every 4 years. Okay. Leap year comes in once in every 4 years. Okay, and how to calculate leap year? If the year is divisible by 4, then it is leap year. If the year is divisible by 4, then that year is a leap year. Okay. But here there is an exception. There is an exception. Centuries should be divided with 400. Okay. So first, if you wanted to know whether the year is leap year or not, we need to divide it by 4. And in exception case, centuries will be right. Centuries means 1900 year, 2000 year, and 2100 year, 2100, all these years will be right. So these kind of centuries, we need to divide by 400. Then only we will understand whether the year is leap year or not. Okay, if the year is divisible by 4, it's a leap year. But in these kind of centuries, we need to calculate, we need to divide these years not by 4 but by 400. Okay, so now let's start solving the problem of calendars. After solving the problems of calendars, we will learn about clocks. Okay, 8th April 2005 is Monday. If 8th April 2005 is Monday, then which day came on 8th April 2004? Okay, the question is, if 8th April 2005 is Monday, which day came on 8th April 2004 is the question. Okay, so how to solve this? First, what they are saying, 8th April 2005 is Monday, right? What they are saying, 8th April 2005 is Monday. Now what we need to calculate, we need to calculate the previous year, same day but previous year. Now what we need to do is, first we need to see whether 2005 is leap year or normal year. Okay, so coming to the 2004, okay, so first let's see whether 2005 is leap year or not. What we need to do, we need to divide 2005 by 4. It is not divisible. Okay, so it is not a leap year. When 2005 is not divisible by 4, it means 2005 is non-leap year. Okay, non-leap year. Now what we need to do is, we need to divide 2004 by 4. It is divisible, so it is a leap year. Okay, it is a leap year. We understood 2005 is not leap year and 2004 is leap year. So now what, in 2005, as it is a non-leap year, there will be only 365 days, which means 52 weeks. And coming to the 2004 year, it is a leap year, so it has 366 days, which means it has 52 weeks plus one odd day, right? Okay. So now what we need to do, we know 8th April 2005 is Monday, and coming to 2004, we need to find out. Okay, see, 2004 is a leap year, one odd day, right? Okay, so now what we need to do is, we need to consider this odd day and we need to consider this one odd day, and we need to go one day beyond. Means in 2005 it is Monday, right? April 8th is Monday. And we need to consider this one odd day which came in 2004. And so we need to move one step, that is one day backwards in a week, which is Sunday. With the help of this odd day, we just moved one step beyond, and we got the answer, which is Sunday. So 8th 8th April 2004 is on Sunday. Okay, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. If you want personal coaching or personal training for spoken English, any competitive exams like MCET, ISET, or if you wanted training for the campus place, what you need to do is there is a number and mail address in the description box below. You can drop a mail or you can message or tap through the given WhatsApp number.